Hey guys, here are loads of questions on spooky heat capacity for you. Always have trouble with that word. Specific heat capacity for you. They're units, which are so important to learn because they do come up as a separate question. How to rearrange the equation, and then easy, medium, and hard questions for you. I want you to imagine that we are on a beach. It is a blazing hot day. Maybe it's just after lunch, so we're all feeling full, a bit lazy. Sitting on our deck chairs, and we decide we want to get up and have a drink. So swing our legs over the side, put our feet on the sand, and ouch, the sand is really, really hot. The sand's really hot. So you run into the sea to cool down, and the sea's not so hot. The sand and the sea are different temperatures, even though they've both been outside for the same amount of time. And the reason they are different temperatures is because the sand and the sea have different specific heat capacities. So specific heat capacity is basically how much energy it takes to warm something up. And this is our equation for it. So here we have E, which stands for energy, which you measure in joules. Here we have mass, kilograms. Over here we have T, which stands for temperature. This delta just means change, so it actually means the change in temperature, that's in degrees, and C is the specific heat capacity, and the units for this one are tricky. It is joules per kilogram degrees C. This has come up as an individual question on its own, so make sure you learn the units for specific heat capacity. Now we need to rearrange this equation so we can find mc and delta t. If we wanted to find m, we could say that we need to take these two over to the other side. M is currently times by these two, so we can say that M equals E divided by C delta T. If C delta T, if we wanted to find C, C is currently times by M and by delta T, so we need to divide by M and delta T. So that would give us E over M delta T equals C. And then finally, if we wanted to find delta T is currently times by M and C, so we can say that E over MC equals delta T. There are a set of rules that I want you to follow every time you do math questions in physics. I'm going to use these today. I'll pop a link to the video where I explain them all for you. But I want you to use every single time because it's the best way of guaranteeing you get all the marks. So a block of mass 1.5 kilograms is heated until it has increased in temperature by 7 degrees. The specific heat capacity of the material is 750 joules per kilogram degree C. How much energy was transferred? So our equation, which we need to write down, is E equals MC delta T. Our M is here. This is our mass. So E equals 1.5. Our C is here. This is the specific heat capacity, 750. And the change in temperature is 7 degrees. So if we times all of those together, we get 7,875 joules. Really, really important that you write your units down here. Medium questions now. We can expect these to be slightly more complicated, involving rearranging equations and a little bit of the application of logic. It requires 46.7 joules, so that is our energy, of energy to increase the temperature of a block by 15 degrees, so that is delta T. The specific heat capacity of the block is 6934. Find the mass of the block. So we have E equals mc delta T. And it's really important to write down the equation every single time. Even if you're doing 15 of these questions, write down the equation every single time, because then you'll get in the habit of writing down the equation, which is something that you really, really need to do in the exams. Do not take shortcuts. We don't do shortcuts in physics. So energy, that is 46.7 equals m, which we're trying to find out, times c, which is 6934, times delta t, which is 15. Now you can either rearrange the equation first, or you can do the numbers first. I prefer to do the numbers first. So what I'm going to do is 15 times 6934, and then I'm going to rewrite the equation as 46.7 equals m times 104010, and then I'm going to do 46.7 divided by 104010, and that is going to give me my answer, which I'm going to write at 0.00045 kilograms. Now I know it's not exactly what your calculator says. I rounded the answer. If you are confused about rounding answers, I suggest you go and check out my math skills book or video, which you can get on my obviously classroom site, website, or you can get the video over on my main channel. But being able to round things in physics is just as important as being able to do all the rest of the maths. So these are hard questions now. You're going to expect application of logic, rearranging equations, non-standard units, lots and lots of things going on here. These are going to be very close to the top end of the higher paper. So a 750 gram block, that is our mass of iron, was heated using 0.75 kilojoules of energy. If the starting temperature was 29 degrees, what is the final temperature? So first of all, non-standard units, we have 750 grams. We want to get that into kilograms, so we need to divide that by 1,000, which will give us 0.75 kilograms. We have 0.75 kilojoules. We need to get that into joules, so we need to times that by 1,000, which will give us 750 joules. Now we can start the question, saying that energy equals mc delta t. We have our energy, that is 750. We have our mass, that is 0.75. Our c, because it is iron, we need to look it up on the table. That is 4500 times delta t. So 750 equals 3375 times delta T. 750 divided by 3375 equals delta T, which equals 0.22. Now the question doesn't stop there, because it asks what is the final temperature. If you've just given that as your answer, you have missed off the last easy mark. You need to add that to 29 to give us a final answer of 29.22 degrees, because that's the answer.